What is going on, lunatics? I shot my shot. Let's see how it goes over the next couple of days. I reached out to CZ Binance to see if maybe we could get him on this show, maybe talk about Luna Classic. Now, the odds of that are extremely slim. I'm not sure we're going to get any kind of traction in that. Let me show you what I'm talking about. If you like this type of content, make sure you hit the like button on the way in. All right, so I put out a tweet yesterday, tagged CZ Binance as one of the long-term influencers of Luna Classic. I wonder if there's a chance I can get CZ Binance on my show to talk about it. No difficult questions, just a good conversation about what he thinks about it all. So now, that means that there is some opportunity here, but it's going to take you guys coming down here, sharing this, you know, make it go viral. If you make it go viral, you never know what's going to happen, okay? It's probably very important to get it done right now while it's in the public eye. Hopefully it turns into something. And you know what? Look, a lot of people want to see CZ Binance as part of Luna Classic. And I don't know what the particulars would be on how he would be involved, if at all. But if we don't just say the words, then probably nothing ever happens. So my attempt to get the ball rolling. Now let's talk about crypto. Okay, so there's conversation going on right now about Ledger being adopting Cosmos, can be introduced to Ledger Live, provide a Ledger compatible app as developed and approved. So, and basically what you're talking about right here is to get Cosmos implemented into the Ledger API in the event that that becomes possible, or in the event that that does happen. You guys will know about it. As long as Cosmos is in there, I think that Terra Classic will work with very limited configuration. So once it's in there and once it's ready to go, then we should be fine. Now, as far as meme coins go, we're trying to move very fast today. I want to get you guys as much information as quickly as possible. Juris Protocol breaking out just a little bit. Food still breaking out just a little bit. Garuda X is up. The boys. Boys down pretty much a long way, but still kind of out there. Again, above the purchase price, if you will, from when I got into it. So we'll see what happens with all of these. But let's talk about price action. BLV Labs, definitely not going to go through at this point, I don't think. I only think there's a path forward for it, so we'll see. But look, this is what happened on the charts. Now, yesterday when we talked about this, let me zoom in for you so that you can see it. All right, so right here, I said that we were in this descending channel after being in the previous descending channel and it having a breakout again. Well, let's go to the hour, and then what do we see in the hourly? We see that it did, in fact, a couple of hours ago, break out of this channel, meaning, or at least intending to mean, that a breakout is on the horizon, at least, I would think, up into this next area. Now, based on the full length of that move previously, and this is not, you know, not exact science here, but we're talking about a breakout to somewhere around 14 if it maintains. Now, I would say because we seem to have a little bit of weakening demand at this point, be looking more at 13 as the next big impulse move, but we'll have to see it play out. So the good news is there's a move that seems to be happening right now and a breakout that seems to be occurring, starting slow. But the last time it started slow, you can see that on the chart, started real slow right here, started real slow right here, and then broke out. So maybe we'll just see a continuation of what we've already seen. And that'll be a very cool thing. Now, as far as volume goes, we're up to 58 million in volume. Again, the one thing that makes me concerned is where is the volume coming from? And BTCC continues to be that place where the volume is coming from. Binance having a not necessarily huge day. I still need to look into BTCC and figure out what is going on here. Donald Trump has won the 2024 election and will be your president, the first pro-crypto president. Bitcoin currently trading at around $87,000. This is the ideal moment for effective management of your own investment portfolio. Since 2019, cryptonomy has experienced exponential and substantial growth, with revenue closing near 2.4 billion euros and insurance coverage of up to 6.1 billion on all company assets. Now listen, guys, the big move here for me, in my fixed staking pool, I'm going to go all in on a little bit more XRP. I've got 5,900 XRP right now. I'm going to go into the 9-month for 71% return. We're going to continue. We staked close to 6,000 XRP just now with a 71.8% return over 9 months. This launch pool is blowing up. As you can see right here, OpenServe just went 7x. getting a significant yield off of that. We got 1.9 on Satoshi Dex. We had a 2.58 on Tap Protocol, 2.1 on Talent, 3.1 on Cross. All right, guys, we're going 10 Ethereum into a bronze tier contract, end date November 12, 2025. I expect to make a return of at least a decent amount, 50% profit sharing. When we got that last one, it was 7x. So I'm going to assume here that this is going to be a real good play. If you haven't already, don't forget myself, Dean DCA, Lyft Capital, Aaron Burke. We're all doing articles for this organization. So if you are interested in learning a little bit more about cryptocurrency, then this is the place to go. You want to go to cryptonomy.finance/research. Also, if you haven't already, sign up for their Telegram. The links are in the descriptions down below. And in the next 2 weeks, there's going to be a couple of big updates brought to you by all of us regarding cryptonomy.finance. Start investing now. Because we also have Grove X out here having a lot of trade volume, et cetera, et cetera. Just go down here and we find some of our clever, interesting places. And you know, I just don't know why these numbers are so high right now. So we'll see. And, I don't have an answer for it at this point. As far as USTC, this continues to go down. Now, the interesting thing is, if this continues to go up and this continues to go down, then by these big numbers, seems like manipulation to me. And I'm not saying that it is. I'm just saying that it seems like manipulation. Seems like BTCC may or may not be accurate about that trade volume. That's what would concern me. But the point to it all, I guess, should be that Binance trading is okay for right now. Not great. This is not the big number that we want, but it'll do. You know what I mean? And right now, by the way, Bitcoin up just remarkably. Ethereum has just broken out by about 10% in the last 2 or 3 hours. Like, this is getting absolutely crazy. That does mean, by the way, we might be looking at an altcoin season. If we look at an altcoin season, USTC going to rip to that 7 cents that I gave you before. Luna Classic going to test that all-time high again. Like, it's all coming, right? So we might be in the cut of it right now. I don't know for sure. But what I do know is, make sure you hit that retweet for that CZ Binance thing, right? And let me know what you think, by the way, in the comment section down below about price action. As far as the rest of it goes, no big updates here from Terraform Labs. In just general, nothing really nothing really special out here. And then from Leonardo for Ceramic for the repeg, no update right now on that one, or no new posts from him regarding that. As far as Lunk Dash goes, again, we're just looking at 12,146, but a no for most people on the community spend for BVA Labs. As far as the burns go, again, continues to just move up a little bit more, 413 million. When we look at Stakebin, what did we see yesterday? We saw 47 million. 47 million is actually not a great day, but it's a good day. That would give us at least 300 million if that were to happen 7 days in a row. So, you know, we're at the very minimum level of enthusiasm. So, and by the way, we had a big burn of USTC today right now, 53,000, which is more than we burned in any day in a long time, right? At least 2 weeks. So this could end up being a pretty good overall day. Now, the burns on Luna Classic, not as robust for the day, but you know what? Who knows? You know, we'll see what happens. Now, if you haven't already, make sure you sign up for Terra Casino. Link in the description down below. Helps me out tremendously. Giving away 2 million euros between now and December 22nd. Still talking funny, by the way. I got my teeth done. Ow. Rich Wild of the Pearl of Vishnu is also available from Terra Casino through Play and Go. And if you're trading meme coins, then Terraport.finance is your place to be. $1 million in trade volume just recently, and they had it multiple days in a row. We've got about 8 days left on our stake. And as far as Selenium goes, it just seems like it just dropped off a rock here. I'm stuck at 9,082. So it says you should have an average. The daily average should be 10,000 Terra. My daily average cannot be this, like, it just seems like it's a little bit weird here that it's been, I feel like it's been about 30 days and I've had over 10,000 for at least 2 weeks, I want to say. But, you know, we'll see how this plays out as the days go on. So that's it for right now. That's your update. I got to go. Look, I think that, you know, we're in the spot here where the altcoin season could be kicking off. If that kicks off, then the party's on, and we're going to have a huge move coming up very, very soon. Now, Is that definitely going to happen? Yes. Is it definitely going to happen now? I don't know. Right now, again, we're having a breakout on a lot of different altcoins that would lead to an altcoin season. And maybe we see something happen, or maybe we don't. I don't know. But if anything happens, I will keep you informed as best I can. Remember, it's not financial advice, but I'm always right.